workout today. I have had lots of requests which have said, hey, can you do a drum solo? And today we're going to be doing a drum solo, and we're going to make sure that we're getting a lot of work going on in our abdominal area, which is really good for squeezing in the sides and making you feel toned and amazing. Getting that waist to feeling like getting today. Come on. And also having an amazing time. Are you ready? We're going to work warm up. Also, like, subscribe, seriously, if you want to hear some more videos and become happy, basically. Okay, so we're going to start with our feet together, slightly hip width apart. We've got our hips from one side to the other. We're going to roll our hands coming up here, stretch, and take it back down. Now, you've seen this before, but I use it because it is really the best. We're working from our ankles, we're working through our body, we're working up into our armpits. We're literally letting our arms stretch all the way. We're bringing heat to our body every time your arms come up. So if you smile, because I think there's something like 36 muscles inside your, I could be wrong, inside your face. I don't know, whatever. Research it, comment below, don't you? Okay, from here, shoulders back. Really big this time. We're really going to be working a lot on the shoulders. We're going to be doing a little bit of shoulder stuff today. Take it forward. Make it big. Okay, stepping out. What we're going to do is hips come forward, take to the side. Hips come forward, take to the other side. So you have this really beautiful stretch on the back of each leg at the same time. Squeeze pelvis forward. Squeeze, send the glutes back. Squeeze, side. So we're hitting the body and at the same time, we are stretching. Lovely. From here, we can take the swings coming up. Swing. Two more. Two. One. Hold. Isolate the top half of the body. Keep the hips where they are. One, two, three. If you're new to my channel, then you'll maybe just realize that. Otherwise, we do speak about this quite a lot. It's all about being able to do one thing with one part of the body and then maybe keep the other part of the body still, or otherwise doing some layering so they're both doing something different, okay? Stretching all the way up, take it to one side, hold. Lovely. Keep those heels up back. Take your arms forward. Hips. Rotate one wrist. This is too far for you. Just take it slow. Up back. When we take these rotations in our wrists, we act like we're scooping ice cream. Both ways. We're alternating knees and making sure that we don't lock our knees at any point. Keep it nice and soft. Up. Okay, so we're used to the rhythm now, and that's what we're going to be doing, a drum beat kind of thing too. So we're going to start on toes, I'm going to get those knees working, send it all the way back down and up. Sides, and then I take it down very sharply. Lift, down, lift, down. So these piston drops are lift, sharp, down. But really working is for your obliques. Down, lift, down. Let's do four, four. Lift, squeezing up. Not out to the side like hip kick, up. Three, two, one. So you can feel that control ready. Okay, shimmy that out. Let's start going one at a time. One, 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 one. So what we do is we bend one leg, one knee, my feet are flat on the ground, and then we sharply switch knees, squeezing into the side, okay? Up, up. Your feet are grounded, but we're really squeezing into the glutes. If you're not feeling that energy across the whole body, then you're not squeezing hard enough, okay? Up. First step. One, two, three. One, two, three. Try and release all the tension in the shoulders, okay? Release all the tension in the eyebrows. Keep that smile. If you're a beginner, just keep it slow. From here, what we're going to do is take it up a point. So we're on our toes now. This gives us the ability to do level changes. And we're going to keep going and squeezing into that side. One, two, three. If this is too much, don't worry. Stay on the ground. This is very much core stability to keep you up here. You want to go forward, don't. This time we're going to do the first move, which is taking it down. We go one, two, three, four. Down. At the same time as going down, we level change down. Down. We level change down. Down. We level change down. Trust your body. If it's too far going this far down, just stay up as high as you want to be. Okay? If you want to stay in this far, stay. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Otherwise, one, two, three, four. And if you're up for a real challenge, take it level. Lovely, two more. Lovely, just roll out those nice ankles. Roll out the other ankle, and I'm going to teach you the next move. Okay, the next move is simply chest circles. So let's just stand with bent knees here. We're going to start isolating the core, get those abs working. Lift, down. Lift, down. Shoulders relaxed. Put your hands on your hips to help you lift, lift, lift. Keep that pelvis tucked in. Keep going. So you don't want your glutes out. You want to stick it under a little bit so you have that neutral. Okay, from here, what we can do is take to the side. Down, side, lift, side. Down, side, lift, side. Really let your body stretch. Now, the stretching part comes with time and practice. If it doesn't show, don't worry. Make sure you can just feel it for now. First time I did this, I couldn't see anything in my body, but I was like, I feel something tiny moving. The stretch comes with literally stretching the body and doing everything. Other side, side, down, side, up. This is a triangle shape. But yeah, side, down, side, up. Lovely. Take it for full up. Take it for the full to the side. Lovely. Let's rotate. Bend those knees. Hips forward. Big circle through the chest. Up and around. Other side. So there we go. Other side. One, two, three, four. Other side. One, two, three, four. Can you stop feeling in the core? Again. One, two, three, four. And the other side. This is how it goes with music. We go down. One, two, three, four. We go round, hands come out. One, two, three, four. We shimmy chest forward, up. Shimmy, let's just practice that. Back, forward, back, forward. You can never practice shimmies enough, okay? Why? Because there's actually a technique to it. Sometimes the chest just wants to move, that's fine. But don't forget that big back space before you come forward. If you go forward, sometimes it's okay, but really want to keep it open. So let's just practice it. Practice one hand. Feels weird, doesn't it? Practice the other hand. What usually happens is your fingers are like, let me join in. And no, stay still, fingers. So, one, two, three, four. Chest, chest. One, two, three, four. See if you can get that down with the chest up. Hands down. Just give it a little bit more variety. If you're not advanced, last one. Now. So we're going to start with these soft knees. We've got Egyptian shimmy happening here. So we've got knee bend, other knee bend, other knee bend, other knee bend. But never locking the knees, so it's soft. Okay, the Egyptian shimmy is a lazy shimmy. Okay, you're lazy. Which means they don't really need to feel relaxed. Now to be honest, keep going by the way while I'm talking. While I've had many teachers who have said, be relaxed, be relaxed. And I was like, I can't relax. This is really hard stuff, you know. I can't be relaxed. And then I realized that it just comes with practice. So when you do this a billion times, one day you'll be relaxed and it will happen, okay? So you're going to keep them really nice and sharp this time. And then your belly goes side to side and then the vibration happens around the belly area. And you want to keep the upper part of the body nice and controlled. So it might shake a little bit as you squat, but it's not like, yeah, it's just, you know, honestly, heels down, okay? When you start training, train with the heels down. You want to do this, which is how I began, and I was, it stopped me doing a lot of layering, which is why I always say do this. Otherwise, if you're not feeling it, just change it. Just do a wobble, so that will just be your hips. If you're a beginner, just let your hips go from side to side. This is your dance, okay? Okay, so we're here. Did you hear that last bit? Pop. That's the bit we're going to be working on here. Okay, so we go pop. So we flick the wrist, pop. And then we go straight into it. This is difficult. You can do a little heel drop into it. This is difficult. Otherwise, just go pop and then just start your shimmy, okay? Otherwise, pop. Okay? And then it doesn't matter how fast you go today, we're practicing, and we're only doing it for that duration of okay? Thank you. do whatever we want on that pop. Okay, we're gonna go through it now. A few times standing without bending to make it easier, otherwise bend. And then we're gonna try to do it again, this time with the bending, and we're gonna hop around the world, okay? Get that core working. Make these big, make them strong, okay? Here we go.
Workout.